Hello and welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and today we're going to dive out to our Ubuntu system and take a look at managing our Vagrant machines. But this time, instead of managing virtual machines within VirtualBox, the default provider, we're going to take a look at different providers and we're going to be using the Libvirt provider so we can manage our KVM machines on Linux.
Remember, we're helping you learn Linux.
So, welcome to the command line of my Ubuntu 18.04 system. I'm still running in this system Ubuntu 18.04, but you could equally run what we're about to see in later versions of Ubuntu. Now, we want to be able to install KVM and the Libvirt management system, so we can show you how you can use Vagrant, not just with VirtualBox, but you're able to then use Vagrant with a heap of providers. Now, I already have Vagrant installed. If I go through and run Vagrant and plugin list, we're able to see that out of the box, Vagrant installed Libvirt, or at least from my installation, I installed this from the default repositories within Ubuntu. You might have to install it, and it would be Vagrant plugin install, Vagrant-Libvirt. But we need to make sure we've got the correct hypervisor. If I go through and run the command kvm-ok, it will check that we've got the correct support needed, so we know we can support our virtualization. I can clear out my screen and run my sudo and apt update. And with this done, we know we've got the up-to-date metadata and we can install our KVM and Libvirt utilities. So with this, then we're going to go through and do sudo and apt install. We can just go ahead and do it. We don't need the prompt. And then qemu-kvm. We can put on then our libvirt binaries. So dash bin. We can put on our bridge utilities for managing the networking. And we can put in then the main management tools. So virt install. With that done, we can go ahead and allow this to install. Now, of course, in your own environment, if you're choosing to use KVM or Libvirt as your hypervisor, then chances are you would have this installed already. So you wouldn't need to go through and install it. Obviously, the hypervisor that you choose as a backend to Libvirt is really down to you. And I think there are about 31 different plugins for providers that are currently available. I can clear out my screen now this is done. If I look at the ID command, I don't belong to the right groups. To be able to manage my virtual machines, I need to belong to the KVM and Libvirt group. So I can go through and do a sudo user mod minus append to my secondary groups and adding in then Libvirt, comma KVM. We can add in two groups that I belong to straight away. And of course, it's going to be for my user account. So $user is going to be an easy one, but I could just do it for Tux. Now, having done that, if I run the ID command again, I don't see membership of those groups, but group membership is on login. Now, I'm in a graphical environment, which means I'd have to log out completely. But a quick way of doing this is just doing su minus. I can open up a new login shell for the Tux user account. Obviously, I'm authenticating here, but this is going to give me a brand new shell. And when I go through and take a look at the ID command now, we can see that I belong to those groups. So as a temporary solution to save me logging all the way out, I just need a shell with the correct group memberships. So this is a nice way to do it. I'm going to go through into my Vagrant directory where I keep all my Vagrant environments or projects. So we can go through cd into Vagrant. I can create a new environment or project directory, so mukdir. I'm just going to call it test. I can't think of anything. It's early in the morning. I can move into my test directory. And of course, it's going to be empty, but I can create a new Vagrant file. I can go through and do a Vagrant init, if I can spell Vagrant, of course. And then we'll call it, say, CentOS 7. And hit the big enter key on this. So that's created my Vagrant file. This is the same thing we saw in my previous demonstration where we're just looking at getting Vagrant up and running. But now to start it, I can use Vagrant up, but I have to then specify the provider because we don't want to use the default provider. So it's going to be provider equals and then libvirt. Now I could also set an environment variable where I set my provider if I'm going to be using this all of the time. But for the moment, I'm just going to set this. And we can see now that it is setting up the default machine with the libvirt provider. We've got to find the correct box. So even though I had a CentOS 7 box, it didn't support libvirt. So we've downloaded or are downloading the correct box. You can always go through to the Vagrant Up website to check the boxes that are available. And of course, you've got to check that they have been created for libvirt, but it's easy to sort on the filters there. But we can see now we've added the box, we're starting it up, having cloned it. And again, we get a slightly different output, but it doesn't really matter. We're waiting for our IP address. Once we've got our IP address, we'll be waiting for the SSH service to start. And then, of course, we can manage this in pretty much the same way. So, yep, we're now connecting into our system, adding in then the keys. And we can now just go through and manage it in pretty much our standardized way. And this is what's good about Vagrant, is it now just becomes exactly the same thing as we were using before, Vagrant SSH. And of course, now that's taken me on to my CentOS 7 system. And even if I could spell it correctly, it might even come up with the information that I'm hoping to see, where we can see, yes, there you go. We've got the CentOS 7 system up and running. So whilst this is very good, if you're only going to be using, let's say, libvirt, so if all of your concentration and maybe the only hypervisor that you've got, then probably you don't want to have to worry about providing the provider information each time. So what we could do, if I clear the screen here and make sure we jump out, I'm going to be working on my host, I can go through, maybe in a login script, we can go through and set our environment variable where we can go through and put our Vagrant underscore default and then underscore provider equals libvirt. So obviously I'm doing this from the command line, and I say you can do it from the command line, but presumably if you really wanted this to be the default, you would put it into a login script. Then I can go through and say maybe do my Vagrant down or Vagrant halt. And now I'll be able to run my Vagrant up. And I won't need to specify the provider, even though I went and created a new virtual machine. But we can see we're bringing it up with libvirt provider. So a lot just depends on what you want to do with KVM and Vagrant. But if, let's say, KVM is your only hypervisor that we're using, then almost certainly setting the default provider makes sense, just so we don't have to worry about that minus minus provider switch. But there you go, we're seeing more and learning more about Vagrant. And Vagrant is really good for me because obviously I'm creating virtual machines all the time for different demonstrations. But it could also be important within our DevOps environment where you're creating solutions for different virtual machine types. Or even if you're just trying to learn Linux and a range of Linux different systems and distributions, as well as the software that goes with it. So it is a really good free open source tool that you want to become more familiar with.
All that is left to say is thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed this, then you are probably sadder than I first thought. For more of this drivel, please subscribe, like and comment to @TheUrbanPenguin.